Hello, headhunting housewives and headhunting guys out there. Today I'm going to answer the question for one of the men that found me on YouTube and had a quick question. Sorry, I feel very unprofessional these days. We're still in corona days. It's May 1st, so I'm not even like getting dressed for these interviews or these videos like I used to. But the question was about business development, and you had asked about how you stay motivated to do the business development side, because it's really hard to get up and focus on finding clients when there are so many candidates coming at you on your email. You wake up, and if you post a job, you have a ton of candidates to get back to. The second you start calling candidates and interviewing, that can suck up a whole day pretty easy. And you can feel really busy talking to people all day. But if you're not hiring those people with your client and keeping your client happy, you're just spinning your wheels. You're not making money or being efficient, right? So, you know, I think everyone finds their own methods. All I can really speak to is what's worked for me through the years, because I'm not a naturally disciplined person. I definitely wasn't like that as a young kid. Even with organization, it's taken me years to kind of become more organized and disciplined and put in templates for my kind of life and calendar that work. So I can share what's worked for me. You might take the same time blocks that maybe I have that work and put those in different time blocks in your calendar. But I think the key is just to have that space and time block somewhere saved. And so, for example, the first thing I would say if you're having a hard time focusing on biz dev is just to have a set time every day that you're going to give it its space, right? So for me, let's say for many years, and I've kind of again shifted in different ways and evolved through it. But for many years, it was the first hour of my day. So when I would come to my desk, whatever time that may be, let's say it was like 7 or 8 or 9, you know, when kids were young, but whatever it might be, you'd be at your desk. And before you jumped right in with the candidates, I would say, okay, who am I calling? And it can be as easy. You don't need any fancy Salesforce, you know, databasing system or client management system. It can be your pen and paper, and you have a list that you're going down of who am I focusing on today, who am I calling? And again, calling might be more of an emailing or follow-up or a LinkedIn with a note. And the key, just like the candidate side and recruiting and everything, is consistency. You're not gonna get that client on the first call or second call. Time needs to go by to see if that relationship is gonna build. So what you need to do is just have a system to, you know, reach back out to them. So if you have a system already of hourly, you're just focusing on business dev and you have a list of people, maybe 5 to 10 clients you want to focus on that morning, really week to week and month to month, then you want to circle back to those originals. So only get so far in your list. Maybe there's 20, let's say, or top 10 or 20 you're focusing on. But then like a month later, you want to follow up again. And maybe then it's quarter by quarter, you know, you figure out just a system where you're writing in notes down who you're calling and when. Again, some people like just a notepad. Some people I know use a spreadsheet. I've gone from notepad to Excel spreadsheet. I feel like I've gone the distance to using all kinds of client management systems, from like the high-end Salesforces to just simple things like the Axe out there. It used to be the Gold Mine, and there was the Bullhorn, and there's all different systems for both candidates and clients. But at the end of the day, 20 years later, I still use my pen and paper. I still use an Excel spreadsheet. I've gone through, like I said, multiple ATS systems because I've often matched my clients, and they've used all of them, it feels like. Of course, the really big ones now, like the Taleo and different ones out there, but and Oracle, you know, but basically just find what works for you and keep it simple. That's my best advice that works for anybody. Because even once you get the more complicated systems, they might work great for you. There's always upgrades, there's calls, changes, things just change constantly. If you're a pen and paper, you're always in control of that. Even I don't have with me, but I used to have, it's actually up my shelf, a little, you can probably see it right up there in the top shelf, is an old little index card box I would use. I put all the months in, January to December. Each month would have week 1 to 4. And on the little index cards, I just put the client that I was calling and then move them back the next quarter, or maybe I wanted to follow up the next month, put them in the next month. I still use that for my life. I have a bigger box that I do for my managing my life, like when the window should be cleaned or when to call to get prices changed in Verizon, or when to dewinterize a rental unit or vacation property. I mean, so I have everything online. I mean, my bills are online, but in my files, I still have, if IT went to hell and everything got shut down, or Salesforce wanted to charge me $1 million, or, you know, all these different things I use to help me, I could still, you know, write a check function, you know, by paper. So that's probably a lot more information you want to hear, but this is a system, you know, have that system in place. And as far as motivation, I think the Headhunting Housewives group is good for that because we have weekly to-dos, you know, like when we focus on candidates, when we focus on the clients and even on our finances. You know, I have things set in my calendar. So whenever I can share that with you, if you want to duplicate that, just to keep it simple, I'm happy to. So again, if you want to join one of the happy Headhunting Housewives, we are happy, but the Headhunting Housewives groups, just to help you maintain the flow and hear how others are doing it and have that support, or just kind of if you need someone like myself on the daily or on the weekly to push through wherever you're stuck, you know, look us up there too. But hopefully this is helpful. And that's that. So have a great day and happy hunting. Bye.